Hi class, today we're going to take a look at how to factor something where you don't have an a value that's 1, but yet you still have 3 terms. Our shortcut norm no longer works when we have that situation. So remember, we always have our two question process. And our first question is always, is there something in common? And sometimes when you ask that question, you can make it so that the a has a value of 1, and you can continue factoring using your shortcut for 3 terms. However, if you look at this example right here, our a is 2, and there's nothing in common, so we can't factor that 2 out to make it so we can do our shortcut. So our next question is, how many terms? And this particular item has 3 terms, and we don't have an a of 1, so that means we have to do something other than our shortcut. Over here on our right hand side, we're going to keep track of the steps that we're going to follow. These are very systematic steps. Some places call this method the AC method, and every single time they work. There is another method called guess and check, but sometimes when you're doing guess and check, it's easy to miss one of the possibilities that might end up working. And if you follow this process that we're going to do here, it will work every single time as long as you stay systematic with it. So we're going to keep our steps over here, and we're going to take a look at this particular problem. And under our steps, the very first thing that we want to do is multiply a and c. And if you notice in our problem, our a is 2 and our c is 5. So if we multiply those two together, we happen to get 10. And then the next thing that we want to do on our steps is we're going to list all the factors of a times c in pairs. And there's going to be a reason why we do the pairs, so we'll do that over here off to the side. Now, you need to take into consideration, we could have positives and we also could have negatives. And since this is a positive 10, we could have positive 1 times positive 10, or we could have negative 1 times negative 10 in order to get the positive 10. We could also have 2 times 5, or we could have negative 2 times negative 5. And those are going to be all our possibilities, because 3 and 4 don't go into 10, and 5 is already up there. So now let's take a look at what we need to do with those factors. This third step is we're going to determine the pair of factors that add up to b. And if you look at our problem, b is 7. So since b is 7, we need to look at these factors over here and find the pair that adds up to 7. And notice 2 times 5 is 10, and when you add them, you get 7. So we're going to use 2 times 5. Now let's see what we do with that 2 times 5. Our next step is going to be to rewrite the quadratic as 4 terms. Now, notice that if your problem has 4 terms, we have a little note here that says start here, because everything we do from here on out is exactly what you do when you have 4 terms. So if your problem already has 4 terms, you're going to use the steps starting at step number 5, because in step number 4 we actually create 4 terms. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this 7x, and what we just found out from this 2 and 5 here is that when our factors were FOIL'd out, the terms that were like terms that added up to get the 7x were a 2x and a 5x. And it doesn't matter which order you put those in, you're still going to come out okay in the end. So I'm going to just put 2x plus 5x and then carry down the rest of the problem. So we have a plus 5 here, and we have a plus 2x squared here. Now that we have 4 terms, step number 5 here is going to be to group them. So I'm going to group my first 2 items and my last 2 items. And then I'm going to go ahead and move this over where we can see it a little better. And I'm going to factor out what's in common in the parentheses. So if I go ahead and take a look at the first set of parentheses right here, they both have a 2 in common and they both have an x in common. So what we're going to do is factor out a 2x. When we do that, 2x goes into 2x squared x times, and 2x divides into the 2x one time. A lot of people forget this 1 right here. You need to make sure you take what's out here and divide it in and leave what's left, even if it is just a 1. Now let's take a look at the second parentheses. And over here I notice there's a 5 in common. So let's factor out a positive 5. 5 goes into 5x x times, and it goes into this 5 just once. Notice our parentheses match now. This parentheses is an x plus 1, and so is that one. And since they're being multiplied by something out in front, we can treat this as one large term, and this is one large term. Notice both of those terms have an x plus 1. So that brings us to our next step here. On our next step, we're going to factor out our parentheses. And our parentheses is an x plus 1, so let's factor that out. And if you factor out an x plus 1 in our first item, you're just left with a 2x. And if we factor it out of the second one, we're left with a 5. And this is the factored form of our original problem. Now, it's always good to check your answer. So there is an eighth step here, and that eighth step is to check. So always make sure that you check your answer. We're going to check this x plus 1 times 2x plus 5 over here by foiling it out. So I'm going to distribute my x. X times 2x is 2x squared, which is the 2x squared in the original problem. X times 5 is 5x, and then 1 times 2x is 2x, and 1 times 5 is 5. Notice that's the 5 from the original problem, and when we combine these like terms, we get that 7x that showed up in the middle. This eight-step process will work every time. It's really 7 steps and then a check at the end to make sure that you did everything correctly. Now, let's take a look at one of these problems where we're doing the same exact thing, but there happens to be a common factor also, because there's something special that I do when that's the case to make it so I can keep my work all nice and organized. So, let's say that we want to factor the problem 3, oops, let's go ahead and 3x squared y Let's say we want to factor the item 3x squared y plus 7xy plus 4y. First thing I notice is I do need to ask myself my first question of, is there something in common? And I notice every single term has a y, so let's go ahead and factor that out. Now, when I factor that out, what I'm going to do to separate it from the rest of the problem is I'm going to use a square bracket, which is my nice little trick to help organize. A parenthesis here would get confused with the other parentheses we're going to put in later, but a square bracket is another type of grouping symbol, just like a parenthesis, that will separate things out and make it so we can distinguish between what we're working on and what we've already done. So use a square bracket there, and then if we factor the y out, we get 3x squared plus 7x plus 4. Now, if you look at what's left inside here, we do have three terms, and the first term does not have a 1 for the a, it's got a 3. So we need to use our steps we found over here. And the first thing is to multiply a times c. And 3 is a and 4 is c. So we're going to do off to the side 3 times 4, which is 12. And then we're going to follow our second step of listing all the factors. And 12 can be a 1 times 12. It could be a negative 1 times a negative 12. It could also be 2 times 6, a negative 2 times a negative 6. It could be 3 times 4, or it could be a negative 3 times a negative 4. And I notice I'm looking for a 7 in this particular problem. And the 7 shows up right here with a 3 and a 4. If there had been an 8 in the middle, we would have used 2 and 6. A negative 8 would have been negative 2 and 6. If we'd had 13, we would have used 1 and 12, or a negative 13, negative 1, and negative 12. So you always want to just check what your B is and look for the pair that adds up to that B. Now we're going to go ahead and, because 3 and 4 made the 7, we're going to go ahead and separate the 7x up into a 3x plus a 4x, which is our step 4 here. We're going to keep everything in the square bracket and carry the rest down. Now we're ready to group things. So we're going to group our first two items inside our square brackets and our last two items. The first two items here have a 3 and an x in common, so we'll factor a 3x out. And we're going to go ahead and carry down our y. And then 3x divides into 3x squared x times, and 3x divides into 3x one time. For our second parentheses, I notice they both have a 4 in common, and it's a positive 4, so I'm going to factor out a 4. And 4 goes into 4x, x times, and 4 goes into 4 once. Notice now that the x plus 1 is in common, so let's factor out our x plus 1. When you do that, you're left with a 3x plus a 4. Now, we can check this. Now, checking something like this is a little bit more difficult. I'm going to do it over here. And when we check, we're going to distribute our y at the end. So what we're going to do is we're going to have y times our x plus 1 times our 3x plus 4. And since you can multiply in any order you want, I'm going to multiply these two first, and that answer is going to be in this parentheses. And then at the end, I'm going to distribute my y. The reason why I do that is because a lot of people will distribute the y into the first parentheses and then do it again into the second parentheses, and that causes an error. If you FOIL these first and then distribute your y, you prevent that error. So let's go ahead and do our x times our 3x to get 3x squared, x times the 4 to get 4x, 1 times the 3x to get 3x, and 1 times 4 to get 4. Combine these to get our 7x. Carry the rest down. And then now if we distribute our y, we get our 3x squared y plus our 7xy plus 4y. And that's how you factor things that have three terms and the a is not 1.